Have you ever been to a meeting or a class and not connected to the speaker? Regardless of your job, you will need to express yourself clearly to others at work and at school. Presentations may not be a part of your daily work, but occasionally you may need to present information to others. If you cannot create an effective presentation, your message will not be heard. After identifying the purpose, developing a profile on your listener is the next step in preparing a presentation. You must determine your listener's interests or needs. Then you can relate your message to something they want to hear about. Some things to consider would be, what do the listeners like or dislike? What is the expertise of the listeners? What responsibilities do the listeners have? Are the listeners decision makers? You can use this information to anticipate any objections your listeners may have regarding your ideas. An objection is a reason to disapprove or reject an idea. When you anticipate these objections, you can decide how to address them. Storyboard, which is simply sketching out and organizing your thoughts and ideas, the next step is to develop the message. Your presentation will have three main parts: the opening, the body, and the closing. Each one plays an important part in achieving the goal you have set for the presentation. The opening is just the beginning statements of your presentation. These statements should be attention-grabbing, like, hey, let me show you how to save $100. Briefly introduce yourself and make sure that it's brief. The body presents the main points of the message. Unlike your storyboard, where you could just use simple words, use complete sentences and make sure to support your ideas with evidence. Your closing will summarize all of your main points. Make sure you give listeners any last instructions. For example, if you're asking them to vote, make sure you say, make sure to go out and vote today. Be brief. And lastly, thank the listeners for their attention. In a presentation, visual aid images can be very powerful. A visual aid is an object or image that illustrates a point or concept. The media that you choose for your visual aid will depend on your budget and the equipment you have available. Media simply refers to the materials or means used to communicate. Some media options include transparencies, electronic slides, animations, handouts, posters, flip charts, and electronic whiteboards. Often, presentations are given as a part of a team. Different team members bring different skills and knowledge that can be used to complete any task. Team members may be able to provide broader coverage of a topic than one person could provide. The first step in preparing a team presentation is to select or identify the team leader. This leader will ensure that the team stays focused on accomplishing the objective. Next, it's important to remember that each team member must have a valid role. All team members may not be involved in delivering the presentation, but each should make a significant contribution. Each member should agree on the purpose and objective of the presentation. And as a last preparation, the team should practice giving the presentation as a group.